My name is Katrin, and today I'm going to check out where the LGBTQ community hangs out in Beijing.
We are at Red Dog Bar, where they host an LGBT night every Thursday.
I'm Brittany Bradley, and I'm gender fluid.
I think sometimes I feel like I'm a male, but like sometimes I also feel like I'm a female. Yeah, it just totally depends on like my feeling. Like I'll come here like when they have like Thursday. Very good place for gathering like LGBT people. Yeah, it's very like safe environment. This is like very opening, and you can like enjoy yourself and express yourself here like without like any judgment.
The bar's owners started LGBT night when there were few places for queer people to meet in Beijing.
Red Dog 是一个 disco bar, cocktail disco bar.
就我的好朋友或者我的团队里面的人都建议我做 gay night， 但是我就一直说我们要把这个活动叫一个 LGBT， 然后 plus night。 准确来说是 LGBT plus， 所以我的每次的海报都会加上这个， everyone is welcome， we open to other communities， 真的是每个 community 都有来，然后他们不光是有这个 LGBT 的，还有真的是一些 plus 的来了，然后一些什么sexual curiosity 的，然后还有就 straight 也有很多人来。 然后当然也很多 gay 和 lesbian 来。
Indeed, I met a straight customer who came to LGBT night.
I am a huge supporter of the LGBT community because a family member of mine is actually part of that scene. It's already really hard to find love in terms of just being straight with your partner, but like for people who can find love of the same sex, I think that's a really magical thing.
I also met Chris, a celebrity of the Beijing LGBT community, also known as Christelle de Conteur in drag.
When did you start doing drag performances?
I started doing drag for about 2 years ago.
And do you like it?
Well, the first night I almost died because of my freaking high heels. My first time in high heels, and it was pointy shoes. And that was a big mistake.
Did you ever face any backlash from the community here in Beijing?
No. Well, except maybe from my fiance. He supports me being happy, and he supports me being able to do what I do, but he does not really support trying.
International student Eduardo has joined LGBT nights before. He feels that the Beijing atmosphere towards LGBT-friendly places is improving.
Thanks to this kind of nights, and particularly on these Thursday nights, it feels really natural to be who I am, even in Beijing. So I almost feel no difference between here and my home country.
I say goodbye to Red Dog for now, until the next dazzling Thursday night.